and welcome to all our viewers around the world. This is a new episode of Story of Success. Each time we'll be bringing you compelling and inspiring profiles. Today we have a very special guest. He's Rear Admiral Yusri Qandil. In fact, he is the first guest from the Egyptian Navy. Let's enjoy the story. Delighted to have you with us. In fact, you're the first guest from the Egyptian Navy. You led our troops in October War, especially the reconnaissance troops of the Navy.
Yes.
Let's dig a little bit into this area of the war.
Reconnaissance is a very important job in the command of the Navy. Reconnaissance mission is to collect and gain informations about the enemy, his naval bases, his warships, merchant ships, because the naval war is economical war, just to deny the sea communications of the enemy. So the naval department, which I was the chief of the Navy reconnaissance, its mission is to gain or obtain information about the enemy in the bases and at sea, and then inform.
In fact, reconnaissance troops are always on the front line.
No, in the Navy, in the sea, and in naval bases. Also in the front line with the armed forces. But especially in the Navy, he gains information about the enemy in the naval bases and at sea.
They set the basic mission of the troops of any war. Aren't they?
Yes, we reconnoitre the warships, the training of the warships, the standard of these warships, the cooperation between these warships and the aviation and other services.
You are the basis of any mission.
Yes, of course, because he can't plan for any operation without information which must be complete and trustworthy. And confirm it. Otherwise, I will give the ships or the troops which will attack the enemy wrong information, which will be in a very critical situation.
In fact, your whole mission is conducted before the attack in general.
The reconnaissance is before the attack, during the attack, and after the attack. Yes. Before the attack, to obtain information about the enemy, to plan. And during the attack, the reconnaissance direct our forces towards the enemy. And after that, the reconnaissance obtain the results of the attack. And after that, the reconnaissance knows the new weapons which the enemy served in this battle, and new tactics. And after that, the reconnaissance give all these informations to all the Navy to be acquainted with it.
If we dive a little bit into the memories of October War, especially for the Navy in October, what would you say?
I would say that the Navy was have main missions, strategic missions and operational missions. The strategic mission is to deny the sea communications of the enemy in the Red Sea and the Mediterranean Sea. You know, after the invasion of Sinai Peninsula, the enemy occupied our oil fields in Suez Gulf. These oil fields give to him about 6 million barrels of petrol every year. And also from Iran, in the Shah, Iran was in the in Iran. It obtains about 18 barrel, 18 million barrel every year from Iran. The sail from Iran towards Hormuz Strait and Bab el-Mandeb Strait through the Red Sea to Eilat, and from Eilat through tubes to Ashkelon port, and then it is refined and sent to Europe. So the mission of the Navy is to deny the sea communication and the petrol from Iran and from Gulf Suez to Israel.
If you say Eilat, we cannot jump without digging into this story, this wonderful story of our Navy.
So there is some confusion between Eilat the port and Eilat the ship. Eilat the port was invaded by the frogmen three times through only 1 year. Although the enemy used much explosives against the frogmen, but they insist to invade the port of Eilat three times during 1 year, 69 to 70. They managed to destroy three ships, Dahlia, Hydroma, and Batiam, and make some destruction in a landing ship. Its name is Becheva. This is concerning Port Eilat in Gulf Aqaba Gulf. The other is the destroyer Eilat, which approaches Port Said, and the motor rocket boats attack Eilat when it enters the territorial water at 21 October at the sunset, nearly at sunset, and it sank. On board the ship, there was about 50 officers under training. They also sank with this ship. It was a disaster to Israel.
What about the preparations for this mission in our Navy?
You see, Eilat have a story. In 1956.
Let's put it to our viewers in detail.
What, sir?
Let's put it to our viewers in detail. The story of Eilat.
Story of Eilat. Eilat, Israel bought Eilat and Yafo, two destroyers, from England at 1956. And in the 1956 war, Eilat and another ship, warship, French destroyer, they managed to capture one of our destroyers, which was missioned to destroy the oil tanks in Haifa. And after it executed this mission successfully, and when returning to the base, Alexandria base, the air aviation attacked our destroyer in the rear of the destroyer. And the radar is not under control, so the two ships, Eilat and the French ship, approached this this ship and managed to capture it. This is the first battle between Eilat and our forces. The second, you know that when Israel occupied Sinai Peninsula, it occupied also the coast of Sinai Peninsula. So Israel must show the flag of the ships in this area, from Gaza to Port Fouad. So it came several times to assure this. One of these times, two motor torpedo boats tried to attack Eilat, but Eilat has more effective arms, guns, torpedoes, and submarine warfare. So it managed to destroy our two motor torpedo boats, which tried to attack. But in this story, the commander of the destroyer Eilat, whose name is Ishaq Shoshan. Ishaq Shoshan said that he met a very brave commander. His name is Avni Azer Girgis. He tried to attack the ship and approach it about 400 meters, which is very near to a big ship like this destroyer. And he managed to fire the side of the destroyer, Eilat, and injure four persons on the deck and destroy the aerial of the radar, of the ship. But unfortunately, when he arrived at about 200 meters, and a shell explode his motor torpedo boat. This is the second time. The third time, it arrived on October 21, 1967. In this time, two rocket boats. The range of the rocket is about 15 miles, about 30 kilometers. So when it approaches to Port Said, and on board of it, the 50 officers which were training on artillery and signal and torpedo. On the dawn, our rocket boats fired their rockets and the Eilat sank towards Port Said.
In fact, these memories shine brightly in the hearts of all the Egyptians. Now I'd like to talk about your beginnings, joining the Navy. Then you were chosen to command a special unit for the torpedo boats. Yes, that was in the 50s. Tell us a little bit more about that.
In 1949. The Naval Forces. I chose the Navy because I have in my mind from the American films the way the sailors' life, how they like the sea, and when they are in ports, what in the harbors they make funny and gay actions. This is the pictures because I was 17. Years when I tried to join the Navy, and also I like the life of the sea, yes, spirit of adventure, because I was at that time sports. I play boxing, I play also.